Welcome you all to the Learning Forward Saturday. Thank you for all our lovely educators from Mumbai, Bali in Rajasthan, and guests who have taken time out to be with us on this Saturday afternoon. We promise you that once you join us one Saturday, you'll love your Saturday even more. And I'm getting excited about telling you that maybe one day you start loving our Saturday matinee and join us instead of going to the movie shows, which anyway are shut for the time being. So welcome aboard the Learning Express. Today we are essentially focusing on the joy of learning, eighth session of the season. I have my co-host with me, Vaishali from Billabong High International School at Mumbai. We are grateful to Rajeshri for giving us the honor and privilege to co-share this session with the Fab India School. And we do hope that both the schools will together take learning forward. Yes, we will be making this session available on Radio LFIN, which became functional just 48 hours back. This will be our episode number 31 on Radio LFIN. In addition, we also have an app. Our radio, as well as all our learning, is exhibited through the app. The app is very simple. You don't have to use www. Just type learningforward.in on any browser, any device. It will work like an app. It will save the shortcut on your device, and that's all it does. It's not hungry for the device. You don't have to install. You don't have to go to the Play Store, because the challenges we find with people when they want to install apps, they have to go to the Play Store. So we don't want you to go to any Play Store or App Store. We simply want you to type in your browser learningforward.in and you are connected with us. You will experience a new joy of learning. That's our promise to you. So cheers to all of you. Values, a module for educators. We did last time talk about why educators, how educators, and what values means to educators as well as the world. Today, when we are talking in this world, we have figured out what is freedom. And peace is even more relevant, because in times of challenge, when freedom has to be curtailed or limited, peace is also stressed. Peace comes from within, freedom comes from out. You should have the freedom of heart and mind, which becomes peace of mind. I sometimes really appreciate, and every session I can't thank our innovators as well as our curators or people who did the presentations by putting the values together. So let us today, in the spirit of freedom and peace, go ahead and take our learning forward. Vaishali, over to you. What freedom means to you?
Freedom comes to me with responsibility.
You already curtailed the freedom when you said responsibility.
Yes. It is the power to act, the power to speak, okay, the power to do what I want to do. So that is what I understand by freedom. And when I feel that I am not, curtailed in the sense suppressed by somebody, don't do this or don't do that, it limits my growth. So I think that if I want to grow, I have to have the freedom to do what I want, to explore everything that I want. So the same thing goes with students as well in a classroom. So when we give them the freedom to explore, to do things on their own, I think growth comes. And that is what learning is all about.
Beautiful. When I look at the visual there, when you talk of freedom, you talk of a cage opening. You talk of the birds flying out, and then you say sky is the limit. And you brought in a very interesting concept here where you said that freedom is bound by responsibility. So it makes me think deeper and it makes me look deeper. Perhaps freedom is to hold your head high. Freedom is in the head. Freedom is in the heart. But freedom may not necessarily be there in the action. So I want to repeat this. Freedom is there in the head, where your mind is without fear and your head is held high. Freedom is in your heart, where you can do what you want. Yet, freedom may not mean you can use your hands the way you want, or you can actually work in a way which perhaps infringes the freedom of another person. Will that be a good explanation, Vaishali?
Perfect, perfect. Yes, that's what... When you talk about responsibility, it's the same thing.
Yes. Yeah. Shivranjana says, freedom is being able to imagine. JG says, freedom is having the ability to change, act, express without any restrictions. Fantastic. Nilka says, real sense of freedom would prevail only if responsibility is taken. Yes, I like that, because taking responsibility is the key, and sense of freedom will only come with response. Freedom is always with responsibility. India got freedom in 1947. There was a responsibility of social equality. There was a responsibility of so many other things which the constitution brought along with our freedom. So freedom did need a constitution, maybe to set a boundary. We say sky is the limit, but there is a limit to how much you can fly. There's no way that you can keep endlessly flying. The bird also has a limit of going to a particular height. The bird does see the sky as a limit to fly out, but the physical aspect of the bird will possibly hold the bird because of the atmosphere, because of the oxygen or whatever is available. There will be some reason where the freedom or the real sense of freedom as you feel will have to be within confines, bounds or the universe. Freedom is being able to imagine. I think that is a very interesting one, and I have to thank Shivranjana for that. Then the beautiful part is Sanika says, there can't be a better time than today to speak about freedom. Quarantine has made all of us realize the importance of being free, about having peace with situation and with ourselves. Freedom is being yourself without anyone's permission. I'm not reading out their names because it just makes the sentences shorter. State of being free, or state of being allowed to do what you want. Pursue happiness without restriction, but not against the law. It's reflecting exactly what the spirit of the house is. Freedom in absence of undue restriction and exercise one's rights and powers. Freedom strengthens wisdom through practical experience. Freedom comes with responsibility, where we are accountable to the reactions. Freedom is oxygen to the soul. Thank you, Ajay. One's freedom cannot infringe upon another's. Thank you for that, Arpita. Freedom for peace. Beautiful. Freedom for peace is more apt. Thank you, Rajeshvi. Freedom gives me happiness. Yes, Vaishali. We love you for that. Sandeep Singh says, the right to do or say what you want. Freedom is not the right to do anything, but the right to do correct things. Thank you, Poonam. Freedom sometimes needs to be demanded. Yes, it could be a command and demand. Doing what you like is freedom. So what we do, now when we look at freedom deeply, is the right to speak, right to act, and right to think freely. You can make a choice for yourself. Facilitates individuals in realizing their true potential. Crucial for pursuit of happiness. So happiness and freedom are linked. Happiness is another value. Happiness is mutual respect. Freedom is where hope grows. Freedom means without fear, like a bird. How beautiful. Feel free to ask questions in a class. Fantastic, Ajita. That is the key. That is the freedom we were looking for, where you feel free to actually ask a question, where you don't feel restricted. That is the answer we all must value. There should be freedom of thought, and there should be freedom to ask a question in a class. It means simply setting yourself free from the burden of adulthood, enjoying being innocent children. Thank you for that, Vijay Lakshmi. So I'm glad we all have the spirit of freedom. We want to take freedom to our classroom, as it was just said. Freedom to ask a question. Freedom to make mistakes. Freedom to think of oneself. Freedom to choose own method of a solution. So when you look at the methodology today, and you're talking of flipped classroom, you're talking of having lead learning by have the peers or the children or the students take learning ahead. That's all freedom. It's all freedom. So freedom for learning, freedom from learning, freedom with learning. Get out of your textbook and emphasize on hands-on activities where concept can be explained. That's what my good school is about. Thank you for that, Ajita. Dare to dream big. That's freedom. Freedom is nothing but the right to exercise your choice. Freedom exhibits the real you. Freedom to play. Freedom in every sense facilitates growth. Thank you, Sharmila. Freedom helps me take a risk. Okay. How much freedom do you allow in your classroom? That is our question. Vaishali.
Like we said in the last session, I would like to, I like that line when sir said that in a classroom, we draw a line, the teacher, the friendship between a teacher and a child. Yes, it is important that teacher and child are friends, but where we have to draw a line, how much friendship should you have with a child? So in the same way, there has to be a line between how much freedom you allow in the class. So that is the fine line that we need to draw. When we give children a chance to speak, we allow them to express themselves, but we do not allow them to cross a certain boundary. Okay, so where if they are speaking about certain things, there is a line which the child needs to draw in a classroom. If they are discussing certain things, there is a line which needs to be drawn in the classroom. If it is related to the subject that we are talking and it is relevant with what we are doing, I think we give them enough freedom to speak, to explore, to talk. But obviously, we should not allow them to have so much of freedom that they do not understand the difference between the where they are. You know, so sometimes when we say that a teacher is friendly with a child goes overboard and becomes so friendly that he does not even realize that sometimes he has insulted the teacher by saying certain things. So, you know, I think that that line is very fine. The child should understand that these are the things, there is a class decorum which they need to maintain, and these are the things I can say, and this is what I cannot say in a classroom or with my peers. So that is what I understand by freedom.
Yeah, great, Vaishali. I have also with me Bharti online, and we are talking of a line.
Yes.
So what we are really saying is that we have to draw the line. That's freedom. And is that it? Draw the line. That's freedom. Bharti, over to you. Bharti, Vaishali left a message here. I know I'm interpreting it the way I like it. But what is your take on this? Vaishali said, draw the line and that's freedom.
Yeah. Means I appreciate what Vaishali has said, that draw a line. Yes, we need to draw a line in a classroom, but we need to give up freedom to our students. Maybe during time discussions, maybe for that, like means what she said, like a line, maybe we can say that we have to set that line according to our learner's pace. And we, by giving them freedom during our discussions or by any work which we are going to give them, the children themselves get that idea that yes, when a teacher has given us freedom, we need to show what our teacher has trusted in us. And through that trust, the student himself or herself takes the responsibility and they also their limits, they too know what is a class decorum and they act according to that. So, means this freedom when we give to a student, it brings trust in them, it gives them leadership qualities, and it removes the fear. Because many times it happens that the students have a fear of the teachers. And that fear can be only removed when we give them freedom.
Absolutely. So what we're really talking of, we're not talking of a line which is sacrosanct, but a line which has a fuzzy logic, which is dynamic. And by line, we don't mean that you can't cross it, but you lay down an agreement between an understanding, if I may use a better word instead of a line. So there's an understanding as to what is right, and that's freedom. I have Rajeshree who wants to say something. Rajeshree Mohito, do I get your name correct? Yeah, Rajeshree, please, you can come on and say what you want to. PHIS, Rajeshree, I've lowered your hand. Okay, I had asked JG to come in at this. JG, when we are talking of freedom and we are talking of an agreement, why do you think there's an agreement necessarily required between a teacher and a child? That's my question. Why do you think we have to have this form of agreement and understanding to enhance the learning experience? Vaishali, would you like to answer that?
Can you just repeat the question? That why do you need to have an agreement?
Yeah, why do you need to have some form of agreement? Because we all agree that it's not a line, but it's an understanding. Yes.
Right.
So when you want to enhance a learning experience, why is an understanding required in terms of freedom?
Yes. When we are in a classroom, definitely we have certain objectives when we are in a classroom that we want to, you know, the objective may be that this is what I have to teach today, and this is how what my learners need to know. And I'll be using a variety of methodology in my class to ensure that my children are learning certain things. So obviously first is to meet the objective of what you want in classroom. Along with, if you don't have a line, if you don't have the agreement, then maybe you will tend to go overboard and probably not meet those objectives which you have planned. It is not necessary that every time you need to meet those objectives, or you need to follow the class decorum, or you need to be within the limits. But yes, at times you do need to have that kind of an agreement between the teacher and the student, so that the learning becomes more fruitful and you are able to guide them towards where you want them to go. So that is why I think it is very important. Otherwise, if the teacher is giving them so much of freedom that everybody is doing what they feel like doing in the classroom, so we are going to totally lose control and we will not be able to achieve what we want.
I have a very interesting comment from Sanika. So what Sanika says, I was going to read her comment and it disappeared. Yeah, it says, to draw this line, we can give them the responsibility of the freedom. The ball has to be in their court. That's her view. Abira says, children should capable to understand that freedom should be for the enhancement of outlook through positive action. Freedom should be for the betterment of the learners and should help the learners in understanding their duties and rights as well. Freedom gives 100% attention on developing long-term skills and study freely. Give students multiple attempts. Failure should be a process of learning and not a final step. That's a very nice one. Freedom is a stage where expressions go beyond limitations. Why can't we give freedom to choose, to learn what they wish? Very good. Real freedom is freedom from the opinions of others. Yes, fantastic. Above all, freedom from your opinions about yourself. That's an interesting element of freedom from Muskan. You have to avoid being judgmental and you have to first uncage your own heart and mind. The fears are within, I always say that. And Ajita says, remove fear from the class, but set the pace and trust your learners. Bharti says, freedom is ability to act or change where we are not prevented for any forces. Freedom helps to take risk. Swatantrata se Atma Vishwas aur Atma Nirbhar banta hai. Dhanyavad Usha. Freedom for learning. Get out of the textbook. Emphasize on hands and activities where concepts can be explained. That's a good one. I want to bring in Krishna Gopal from the Fab India School. I will unmute him. Krishna Gopal. Ji sir. कृष्णा गोपाल जी.
यस सर, गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
आपको आजादी मुबारक.
थैंक यू सर.
मैंने आपको अनम्यूट किया, आजादी तो थी.
जी सर.
अब आप बोलिए आजादी से. कि आजादी का क्या महत्व है, ये फ्रीडम क्या चीज होती है?
फ्रीडम यानी प्रतिबंधों की जो है वो अनुपस्थिति है, यानी आपके ऊपर कोई प्रतिबंध न रहे. जीवन के कई क्षेत्र ऐसे हैं जो दूसरों को सीधे से प्रभावित नहीं करते हैं, तो वहां पर अपनी मर्जी हम चला सकते हैं. ठीक है, इसमें जो है वो शिक्षा हो सकती है, व्यवसाय हो सकता है, और भी कुछ ऐसे पहलू जो है वो हो सकते हैं. इसके अलावा किसी से सलाह लेना, सलाह हम ले सकते हैं, लेकिन करनी अपनी मर्जी की, अपनी इच्छा से करनी, ये जो है वो स्वतंत्रता है, आजादी है. विचारों की स्वतंत्रता भी है, आप अपने विचार जो है वो व्यक्त कर सकते हैं. जी सर.
आप लाइन पे रहिए. प्रलय कहते हैं, विश्वास के लिए आगे बढ़ने के लिए सबसे अच्छा मार्ग आजादी का ही है. मतलब क्या आजादी और विश्वास आपस में कनेक्टेड है? क्या आपको विश्वास मिलता है आजादी से, कि विश्वास से आजादी मिलती है?
एक तरह से यह है सर कि विश्वास से आजादी मिलती है. जहां हम विश्वास रखेंगे वहां हमें जो है वो आजादी मिलना है सर.
तो इसका मतलब विश्वास को कायम करने के लिए हमको थोड़ा सा धैर्य रखना चाहिए और जगह देनी चाहिए, चाहे वो परिवार में हो, चाहे वो क्लास में हो. हमारे साथ लाइन पर देवगन सर भी हैं. देवगन सर लाइन उनकी साफ नहीं है. ठीक है, इसलिए हम ये सब मानते हैं कि हमको थोड़ी सी स्पेस देनी चाहिए और वो फ्रीडम है.
जी सर.
चाहे वो क्लासरूम में हो, चाहे वो खेल के मैदान में हो, चाहे वो हमारे दोस्ती में हो, चाहे वो हमारी रिलेशनशिप में हो. थैंक यू सर. मुझे उम्मीद है आपकी लीडरशिप से और आपकी फ्रीडम से आपके बच्चे आगे जाएंगे. थैंक यू सो मच. वैशाली, हाउ डू वी एक्सप्लेन फ्रीडम इन अ क्लास? हाउ डू वी बिल्ड अबाउट दैट अग्रीमेंट विच यू ऑल टॉकिंग अबाउट? सी लाइक वी टॉकिंग अबाउट गोइंग इनटू अ क्लासरूम.
Yes,
you will have your history lessons and you will talk about what is freedom. India got freedom in 1947. You got freedom. This is what happened in the war. Normally, when you talk of freedom, you're talking of countries and war, and you're talking of war and peace.
No.
And we are talking of freedom and peace today. Just remember that.
Right. Actually, in a classroom, what we can do generally, or we rather do, is that we first tell the child that this is your classroom. Okay, so we give them that authority that this is your belonging. This classroom belongs to you. The children in the classroom are members of your family. And when we say we agree on certain things, we say that every part of this classroom is your responsibility. So we have an agreement with the children that yes, nobody will be monitoring you from time to time, telling you don't do this or don't do that. So we have a set of agreement. We have an agreement where the children make their own agreements and they decide that they will, this is the decorum of the class and this is how we are expected to behave. And after this, it is an agreement by all the children. So there is nobody who is imposing any kind of restrictions or rules on them. They all agree that they should work together. They have the freedom to speak. They have the freedom to express their views. So this is how it will move. And obviously, when we learn to agree with each other's views, we will maintain peace.
Because, fantastic.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah. No, that's perfect. So what happens in a class is not necessary that you will tell them you got freedom from Nazi Germany and that's freedom.
Right.
So that's not the way to do it. So when you say you conduct a discussion in your class and lay down the agreement, that's perhaps is a more simpler way of doing it.
Yeah.
So Rahul says life without liberty is like a body without spirit. Then Abira says freedom boosts the enthusiasm of a child. Baiju says freedom is the right to do right things. He has used two rights. It says it is a right and it's right things. Then Poonam is very simple. Freedom is a state of the mind. You're only free when you realize. So freedom helps learners to explore unknown things. And that's what a class is all about. Whether it's your curriculum or whether it's your extracurricular, you uncover the hidden strength. You uncover the talent. You find yourself. And that's leadership. That's what I say about freedom always. Freedom helps to maximize self-potential. Thank you, Vaishali. Aisha from Fabindia School says, Swatantra se hame apne naye vichar rachmata se jeevan ki gunvanta ko badhane ke moka dete hain. So she's connecting Swatantrata with an element of excitement and new vision and realizing your true potential. With any freedom we offer students, we need to make sure there is a corresponding responsibility and make sure that we provide some structure in those freedoms. The secret of happiness is freedom. So we all agree in this house, freedom is duty with responsibility. And that is education. So if education was freedom, it is as much a duty with responsibility. That's exactly why we say that freedom will power you, empower you, and also understand what is the limit of your power. Thank you for explaining the various aspects of freedom. Bharti sums it up by saying students will find a common ground about classroom management and then the mutual understanding, they will create a healthy and peaceful environment. Yes, fantastic. Healthy and peaceful environment, we've already come into peace. So see how you need peace in the environment. You need peace in the classroom. At the Fabindia School, we've been reading Kavita Ghosh's book. And in the Kavita Ghosh's book, which now forms a core of our program called Diversity, Inclusion and Belonging at School, we talk so many conflicts. We talk of experience versus inexperience. And in the end, we make peace. So making peace with the world, with the people around you, and with an understanding that you have freedom helps enhance learning. Peace also means tranquility, an amicable solution. And more than anything else, peace will help in maintaining calm, dignity and respect. So Vaishali, are you at peace with me?
Absolutely, sir.
Or are you going to mark me to pieces?
No. Why should I?
For asking you to do so much of reporting and writing every week, you'll cut me to pieces.
No, sir.
No? Okay. So if you were not to cut me to pieces and if you're at peace with me, what do you think is the essential element of peace?
Essential element of peace, actually, this particular value is very difficult to explain, you know, because everybody will have a different perspective when it comes to peace. People find peace in different, things. Somebody may find peace in nature, somebody may find peace in reading books. Somebody may be very happy and peaceful while they are sleeping. So I think the concept of peace basically means that they want a mind, a place where they can just relax the mind. And I think that is very important if you want to be happy. Or, you know, it's a sense of a total tranquility, as you said, a sense of satisfaction. And which is very important if we need to move on in this world where we face so many problems and issues day in and day out. So I think peace does not only mean when there is a war that we need to be at peace or between two countries, but inner peace is very, very important for us. So that's what I understand by peace.
You're talking of inner peace, you are reflect. You're talking of calm, dignity, respect, and a poise. You know, I firmly believe that a teacher needs the poise. And Sanket says, peace is satisfaction. Rajeshri says, freedom of expression brings peace. Supriya says, peace is inner silence. Resolving conflict is the key to having a successful class or a great class. I want to bring Shivranjana in. Shivranjana, please unmute yourself. Shivranjana says, I think peace comes from acceptance. We are taught to look at acceptance as defeat, but acceptance of things and people and situations, not fighting or judging them, that is what lends peace to be and to bring solutions where needed. Shivranjana? I think she's too busy typing.
I would like to add here, which is a very important point brought in by Shivranjana probably, that when peace also means when children have difference of opinion and they are in a situation, a conflict situation, and they work together to improve that situation. That also brings peace.
Does that mean that acceptance leads to inner peace?
Yes.
What Sanika says is that there has to be an acceptance. Then only peace will happen.
Absolutely.
Ajita says,
so it will also lead us to the value of tolerance again here.
Yeah, so you got another value in beautifully. You know what Ajita says? She says, you organize the class, learners will feel loved, nurtured, and they will be ready to learn. That's what her meaning of peace is. Nilka says, without peace, it will be impossible for us to learn and create something. Arpita says acceptance leads to peace. If we are looking to others to validation, there is no peace. Kids today need to learn this acceptance from us. See, when you're always testing or when you're always validating or when you're always looking for validation, you will not be at peace. So this concept of acceptance brings the peace which we are all coming together for. So never be in a hurry. Do everything quietly and in a calm way. That's what Rahul says. Peace is absence of hostility. Thank you, Madhubala. Bharti says, peace comes when we have the ability of listening to others. Thank you, Vishali, for listening to me. Ajita says, organize the class. Learners will feel loved, nurtured, and they will learn to love. Mahalakshmi says, tolerance to others, freedom brings in peace. Now, this is a very interesting one. Remain cool in adverse situation. Very simple. Rajeshwari, Rathore, aap apne aap ko unmute kar sakti hain, Rajeshwari? Rajeshwari? I want to encourage her to talk, so let me get Rajeshwari Rathore in. Yeah. Rajeshwari?
Yes, sir.
आपने बड़ा अच्छा वाक्य लिखा तो मैंने कहा आपकी मधुर वाणी से ही सुना जाए इस वाक्य को. आपने कहा शांति विकसिता. आगे पढ़िए. शांति एक्सपीरियंस करने के लिए, विकसित करने हेतु क्या चाहिए हमें? संवेदनशीलता. जी,
दूसरों के प्रति जैसे नम्रता से व्यवहार से अच्छे से व्यवहार करना, नम्रता से सुनना उसकी बात,
तो और आपने
उसको महसूस करके और हल करना कोई भी समस्या हो तो बच्चों के लिए.
तो आपने शांति को महसूस करने की बात कही.
यस सर.
हम क्लास में कहते हैं शांत रहिए. क्या बोलने से शांति महसूस होती है कि शांति को महसूस करने का जबान के बगैर भी हो सकता है?
जबान के बगैर भी हो सकता है सर.
क्या शांति आंखों से महसूस होती है?
यस सर.
जब बच्चे आपकी आंखों में देखते हैं क्लास में, क्या वो शांति महसूस करते हैं?
यस सर.
शांति को महसूस करना और शांति को बनाए रखना आप अपनी क्लास में क्या करती हैं?
शांति को बनाए रखने के लिए सर जैसे कोई टॉपिक है, कभी कभी बच्चे जैसे ऐसा हंसी मजाक का टॉपिक है और बहुत ज्यादा ओवर हो गए, थोड़ा सा जैसे मैं आंख से देखती हूँ तो एकदम शांत हो जाते हैं, वापस अपने उसमें आ जाते हैं टॉपिक के अंदर।
तो इसका मतलब आपकी आंखें भी बोलती हैं और बच्चे शांत हो जाते हैं।
बच्चे शांत हो जाते।
बहुत अच्छा आपने बोला कि टीचर की आंखें भी बोलती हैं, और आप सच मानिए टीचर की आंखें लफ्ज ज्यादा बोलती हैं। बच्चे टीचर की आंखों के लिए तरसते हैं और ये असलियत है जिससे शांति और सहनशीलता क्लास में बनती है। धन्यवाद राजश्री। अजीता सेज क्लासरूम शुड हैव वन टोन प्रमोट्स पीस एंड फ्रेंडशिप। Peace leads to prosperity and growth in every aspect. Classroom peace, harmony, justice and equality. Peace is a gradual change in one's opinion and approach to construct a better understanding. Do not tolerate any kind of bullying in class. That's what Ajita says. Vaishali says, peace leads to development. Vaishali, you're talking of development. What is inner development and what is development?
Sorry, sir?
What is development and what is inner development? You mentioned peace leads to development. So I'm going to counter you with a question. What is inner development and what is development?
Okay, if we talk about peace within two countries, okay, when there is peace within two countries, of course, there is a exchange of, whatever, resources, thoughts, technology. And definitely that kind of a peace will help every country to develop. So that becomes an external development when you are having peace between two countries. But when you are having a peaceful classroom and you are having a play, you are having a situation where you are, resolving conflicts without having, any major, disturbances or agreeing to each other. So definitely that is also a learning, a development that takes place within you. So if you are agreeing to somebody and you are taking suggestions, learning from them, so that also brings out the maximum potential of a child. So this kind of a classroom where you are, being more in agreement with each other, you can, self-develop yourself as well. So it may be external or internal, so both ways.
Good. So I'm glad you tried to explain what is peace within and what is peace outside. I want Yojana to come in here. Yojana, please join us in the discussion.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yojana, you perhaps handle a very large team in your school as compared to my other school. How do you bring about an atmosphere of peace so that all your teachers have the freedom to do what they want in a class?
Sir, I feel having faith, having trust in them is the first and foremost thing which is required. If you want things to be done, you need to trust them. All fingers are not equal. Everybody has some positives, some drawbacks. We need to take everybody together along with their drawbacks, accept them as they are. When we do that, they will get that confidence, and that confidence will help them do better. So when we have a big team, there are conflicts, there are differences of opinions. At the end, we need to agree to disagree. Not every time I may be wrong, I may be correct. I need to understand somebody else's perspective, build on it, and finally take the decision what is right for our learners. So teamwork, discussions, brainstorming at the end will bring us to perfect and correct decisions for our learners is what I normally do.
Yes, absolutely. And you brought in the very interesting element of trust.
Yes.
Which is a value which is reasonably important when you talk of any value, because values themselves are a trust.
Yes, sir.
Values are a bond of trust. Values are an understanding of trust. And when we talk of peace, we don't always have to talk of conflict. You know, like Ronald Reagan said, peace is not absence of conflict. It is the ability to handle conflict by peaceful means.
Right.
So what you have just said is exactly what the honored president of such a huge country said, that how to handle peacefully is what is more important than anything else. And that can only happen with trust.
True.
So the whole bond of a teacher and a child in a class, or a child and a family, or an individual and a society, or a country and the world, it has to be built on trust.
Yes.
So often we look at the, let's look at the world today. We look at every country with a very warped lens. We feel that this country will always be at conflict with us, and this country will always be at peace with us. Now, this perspective itself shatters our inner peace, not realizing that every country is just you and me, is people like us. So when you think of it that way, you will be peaceful. But when you look at it the way as the world politics plays, it will be a conflict. So like you beautifully said, that once we trust every individual, the world will become a place of trust, a place of freedom, a place of joy with responsibility. Am I right in putting it this way, Yojana? Okay. Vishali?
Yes, sir.
Why is it when we talk of peace, first thing comes to our mind is conflict?
Not always it comes as conflict, but it is just a disagreement. And when people disagree, they try to put their point of view. And then our perception may be that we are looking at it as a disagreement or a conflict situation. So even if there is something that I disagree and I try to put my point of view, the person who is in front of me may think that I am trying to counter-argue. So it does not necessarily mean that if I have a different opinion, I'm at a conflict situation.
Rajeshri, Shihab. Vaishali just said something very interesting. She said, even if I may have a different point of view, it does not imply that there is a conflict. What is your view on this, Rajeshri? Okay. Yeah. Vaishali,
Rajeshri. No, I'm back here. Yeah, I was unable to unmute my mic.
Okay.
Could you just repeat the question?
Vaishali, please put the question yourself.
Yeah. Sir asked me that why do you think that when we have to think of peace, why do we think it is always a conflict situation? So I just said that it's not necessarily a conflict situation, but it may be perceived. When I'm trying to prove my point of view, the person who is with me or, in an agreement or disagreement me, perceives that I am having, trying to argue or put my point of view. And that is why they think that I'm in a conflict situation with them. So that is what I have mentioned. So
Vaishali, let me put it differently. What you're saying, the power of expression has its due regard. It should not be considered as a conflict of opinion. Is that right?
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Yes.
So, Rajeshri, power of expression on one side is freedom.
Hmm.
Right? Conflict of opinion is
so freedom.
Hate speech. How do you balance this in your cycle of handling children and in your cycle of handling staff as children vis-a-vis, because they are all individuals who will have a difference of opinion? How do you think you bring about peace?
Yeah, when we say conflict of opinion, basically it is not a conflict of opinion if we make it freedom of speech. Like if I have the freedom to speak, the other person too has the freedom to express, or even maybe which is a conflicting opinion, which can be a conflicting opinion, which we perceive as Vaishali just said, but that can be turned into peace only by just letting the person speak, whether it's a child or the teacher. Giving an opportunity to express is definitely going to lead to peace.
That's a wonderful thought. What you're really saying is that when you let yourself out from your heart and you have a conversation or a hard conversation, it will bring about peace.
Absolutely.
Beautifully said. Shiv Ranjana says, perhaps because we are conditioned to believe that disagreement means personal attack. Therefore, there is the absence of peace. Very nicely explained. JG adds further, peaceful classroom promotes knowledge, skills and attitudes to help students grow and to prevent any occurrence of conflict. So what we're really talking of is that if you have peace, there is less chance of even a conflict occurring. You are free to choose, but you are not free from consequence of choice. Very good one. Trust in the teacher and love for her will always bring peace. Teach students to accept we are friends. Using kind words and taking care of their classmates makes all the difference. Peace is a gradual change in one's opinion and approach to construct a better understanding. Classroom peace, harmony, justice and equality. Peace leads to prosperity, growth in every aspect. Classroom should have one tone, promotes peace and friendship. Peace comes when you have freedom and responsibility to be in harmony with self. Do not tolerate any kind of bullying. We have done this. Freedom and peace create a feeling of ownership and responsibility to look beyond themselves and think about others. So this is a very nice way of summing up the values of freedom and peace. Courtesy Bharati Rao, freedom and peace create a feeling of ownership and responsibility to look beyond themselves and think about others. So what is happening when you're talking of freedom and peace? You're talking of caring, you're talking of sharing, you're talking of loving, and you're talking of standing in heart and soul with each other. That's why freedom and peace are from within and they are reflected without. So you see a reflection of freedom and peace around you, which is the reflection of yourself. If you are in peace with yourself, you will radiate peace outside and there will be peace around, there will be freedom around. So that was a beautiful discussion on freedom and peace. Courtesy the Little Book of Values, which my friend Rajeshri Sihag lives by and loves by. Vaishali. On one hand, we are talking about values, and on the other hand, we are calling them a little book. Don't values need a bigger book?
No, sir.
Why do values need a little book? In a nutshell, why do you want an individual in a value system which is complete? Not constructed by space, but by heart and soul.
Yes. I think values by themselves are very powerful. And every value that we talk about comes from everybody's experiences in life. So I think the Little Book of Value is like a small guideline to the guideline for everybody, which is just, you know, maybe it is something that you have to think on. It is a process. It is not that certain things are meant to be like this or meant to be like that. So the whole process is important. So when we talk about values, it is how we perceive things, how we consider them to be right or wrong in a situation in society. So these values are only like guidelines. For some, they are values set by some people, but they are socially acceptable. And all these values lead to something where it leads to inner peace, inner freedom, happiness, self-satisfaction. So I think that is why the book, the little book, just to say, it is a little book of values, but it goes beyond the word little. There is a lot of thought, action, and discussion that goes in these values. So they are like, you know, those activators. The little book is an activator.
It's I like that. No, that's why they say that little actions make a big difference.
Yes.
And that's all. That's the story of a class. That's the story of relationship between a teacher and the child. Little actions make a go long way.
Yes.
And little expressions, little actions, you hold your hand and become stronger and the bond of trust develops. Once the bond of trust develops, empathy is the next thing that comes into play. Once empathy comes into play, caring will come into the play. Once caring will come into play, courage will come. Once courage comes into play, freedom will be found. That's how the whole cycle goes. I have with me Rajeshri Siha. She has a good word to say. Yes, Rajeshri.
When we talk about the little book of values, it's difficult to carry big things with us. And this little book implies that this is the book, the values that we need to hold very close to our heart, and we should be able to carry it anywhere and everywhere that we go. So it is in a small packet, nutshell, close to our heart, everywhere.
So packet by packet.
Absolutely.
Things change step by step.
Something like that.
Absolutely. Chota packet. So drop by drop. Yeah, absolutely.
It's bada dhamaka.
Bada dhamaka. So every big cracker is made of small crackers. So wonderful. See, that's how energy, atoms of energy, we're always talking that the smallest thing in life begins with the atom. So the smallest change in life also happens with one value at a time. And minute all the values become the garland, which we always talk about and which if we wear, you will give fragrance to the world after that. Poonam says, peace is the result of retaining our mind to process life as it is, rather than you think it should be. So acceptance, that's another form of saying peace. And then there has to be a healthy conflict, which is again brings you peace. An unhealthy conflict will tire you out. Freedom and peace create a feeling of ownership and responsibility to look beyond themselves and think about others. I end up again with this good line of Bharati, which should actually become the paraphrase of our session today. Freedom and peace create a feeling of ownership. Absolutely. We agree with you. And responsibility, even better, to look beyond themselves and think about others. So we're already talking about others, and that's precisely why a moment back I talked of caring, I talk of giving, I talk of having the courage to look within. That's freedom. And peace is within, it's not without, because we're always looking for peace outside. And we're always told peace is inside you. Don't go to pieces looking for peace, because you have to piece it together for yourself. That's what peace is all about. I think it's been a wonderful afternoon, and these joy of learning sessions are actually, often Kalyani says, they are emotionally draining. Yes, they are enriching. And the more stories we come out with, the more stories we write, that's why we encourage you to do your blog posts. The more we understand how important these value of values are. And on that note, I had mentioned in my email to everyone today that it's time now for us to reflect. It's time now for us to stay connected. And more than anything else, it's time now for us to think how we can take this whole story of joy of learning ahead. How we can take the program of Learning Forward India to help people take their learning forward in everywhere in the country. And more important than anything else, I mentioned that we are looking for teachers who will be part of our national training team. It's been my dream for the last 10 years when we started doing school culture transformation, is to put together a bunch of champions across the country who will be able to do these sessions on a weekly basis. What I feel that we should not be just doing one session with one school or two schools, we should be doing 100 sessions a week. And that is not difficult, provided we get about just 8-10 teachers who can do that many sessions. So we want to make it sustainable. We want to be worth your while. We want you to have the freedom to work. And we want you to be with peace with yourself come aboard, take on the joy of learning, and be with us. We will train you, we will help you become mentors, coaches, and we'll help you spread the joy of learning, not only within your community, but in your society, in your school, in your city, and in the world around you. That's how you will prepare children for the future. When we keep saying that, are you preparing your child for the world? We are really saying that you are preparing a child who has all the values to grow up in the world. And that's the key. So if you want your children to be future ready, you have to have teachers experience the joy of learning. And if teachers experience the joy of learning, that's the creation of a happy classroom. If there is a happy classroom, there will be the learning outcomes you're looking for. So learning outcomes, your syllabus, your academic, your extracurriculars will not happen till you can just feel the values, till you can resonate and value at a time, build great character. So here's asking you again humbly to please join us on this mission of value, mission of inner value, and mission of self-fulfillment. So do join us and do volunteer to train. You have perhaps seen in the last few sessions how you can help. We have shown you how people are volunteering. Some can help on helping, how do you write a blog? Some can help, how do you capture the learning from a session? Some can help by actually doing these conversations. You can also become a radio jockey or a radio DJ, and radio LFIN will go very far on the core value module, because you want to focus on this. So do join us, do volunteer. Yes, it'll be sustainable. You will be professionally rewarded. And I'm sure your personal and social development will be your biggest reward beyond just any kind of other sustainable reward. So at that, I want to thank you for the joy of learning. I want to thank each one of you for being with us. And I want each one of you to feel the value and make it worth your own while. Then only you'll be able to build a better classroom.